The Seminole tribe has long referred to itself as the Unconquered. It fought three bloody wars for survival against the U.S. government in the 1800s before escaping to safety in the Everglades. They boast they're the only Native American tribe to never sign a peace treaty. Tiny in number but the dominant Native group in Florida, the Seminoles have emerged from the Everglades as a global gambling giant. They own the Hard Rock Hotel chain, derive billions in yearly gambling revenue, and have a world vision for expansion. Now, they're poised to tighten their grip on gambling in one of America's largest states, barring legal challenges and interpretations. Florida ratified a new 30-year gambling compact with the Seminole tribe in May of 2021, possibly bringing mobile and retail sports betting to a state of 21 million residents.
The flagging paramutual industry would be thrown a lifeline by being able to offer sports betting, but through partnerships with the Seminoles. They would also be allowed to continue offering so-called banked card games. These games were supposed to be a Seminoles exclusive, but instead they became an expensive sticking point. When former Governor Rick Scott refused to enforce that exclusivity, the Seminoles began withholding $350 million annual revenue share payments in 2019. But this deal, negotiated by current Governor DeSantis, might mark a new beginning.
This could be a very big deal for Florida, with at least $500 million yearly flowing into state coffers through a revenue share agreement with the Seminoles. It could be a very big deal for the tribe, further strengthening its control of gambling in the state. And it would be a massive deal on the American legal sports betting landscape, if the compact survives legal challenges and federal scrutiny. The third most populous state in the U.S. has long been seen as one of the far-off prizes of the legal sports betting industry. Florida not only became the 28th jurisdiction to legalize since the repeal of PASPA in 2018, but it's the largest to do so at this point. With Florida in the fold, even California and Texas would seem possible. But this deal is no done deal, even with a signature from Governor Ron DeSantis. Many legal observers believe it won't pass federal muster under laws that regulate Indian gaming, and there should be a flurry of lawsuits from the stakeholders who didn't make out as well as the Seminoles, which is pretty much everyone else. The state of Florida's history with the Seminole tribe is a complicated one. The tribe has a virtual monopoly on casino-style gambling here, and its reach would expand further with this compact. The Seminoles own 6 casinos in the state out of 7, like the Hard Rock Tampa, and would gain the right to offer craps and roulette in this new deal in addition to controlling sports betting.